General, these are your colleagues behind you here, I assume?
Yes.
I want to thank all of you for your good work. I know it gets frustrating sometimes. I want to follow up on Senator Kane's questions about improper payments. You mentioned 79 agencies, and last time I looked, it was about $144 billion a year. That's not a 10-year estimate. That's per year.
Right.
And I agree with you, and I think we've done a good job. You've done a good job in terms of understanding the extent of the problem. What more do we need to do to try to make the agencies take it seriously? And let me tell you what really frustrates me. I understand making a mistake in terms of a payment, but we're paying dead people, for God's sakes. And they've been dead a long time. Now, I've seen dead people vote, but never cash a check. It's obviously fraud.
Yeah.
And yet the Social Security Administration has a master death file. How hard can it be to check?
Well, first of all, we've recommended to Congress, Social Security will not share the master death file with the Treasury Department.
I know. It's,
you and I had this exchange previously. It still hasn't happened.
I know.
That Congress, I've asked Congress to give Social Security Administration.
I'm trying to get a bill passed. I got all kind of people objecting to my bill.
Yeah, I mean, it's one federal agency to another. And the objections are privacy, but it's costing the federal government a large amount of money. I can't believe anybody wouldn't, average citizen wouldn't agree that it makes sense to do that.
I can't believe there are people objecting. I mean, I'm not trying to be unfair to any of my colleagues, but who can be for paying a dead person? That's hard to sell back home.
you won't find any takers at the GAO on that either. But it baffles me, to be honest with you. And the other thing is, under the law, if an agency has improper payment rate of over 10% for three straight years, they're supposed to provide a plan to the Congress to come into compliance with the law. But I can't for the life of me think of when an oversight hearing was held on these agencies that are out of compliance with the law to say, what are you doing to do this? Now, I know I've testified in the past on some of these areas. Now, the problem is, overall, though, it's a cultural problem in the government, and that, you know, the only time people in the agencies get into trouble is for not paying somebody. Yeah. If somebody's not paid and they're not paid on time, so the incentives are to do that, not to make sure you double-check eligibility and that you match records and things of that nature. So we're trying to shift the culture by highlighting the issue. And a number of agencies say, well, it's just, you know, part of it's a documentation problem. We just don't have the papers. You know, my point to that is, look, the IRS, if you don't have documentation for your tax exceptions, government will take your money, you know, but we're going to turn around and spend somebody else's money without proper documentation. So this needs congressional oversight in a big way, Senator. And I know the administration's trying, but they need help, and we could use your help, too.
Well, I mean, another example, and this to me is low-hanging fruit, and I know you see it as well as I do. You know, our Internal Revenue Service, and I know they get beat up on, and I want to try to be fair here, but we assume that they know, the IRS, who's paying taxes and who isn't. And when I see them hiring consultants that owe them money in a final judgment, not a tax dispute, there's a final judgment, and they're contracting with them without offsetting the amount owed the taxpayers.
Yeah.
I don't understand it.
Yeah. No, we've issued reports on that. It's not just the IRS. Other agencies hire contractors who owe the federal government money. Tax debt. And Congress has taken some action, but not more can be done in that area, and we've got recommendations on that. But it's just not, I mean, the... focus on responsibility and ownership. I mean, people wouldn't, I mean, that's why you don't have much of this happening in the private sector, because it's their own money.
I've about convinced, yeah. I'm not going to go too far over here, yeah. but I don't want to be unfair to anybody, but it's easier to divorce your spouse than fire somebody around here. And it just seems to me within the parameters of the law that some people ought to be fired over this. You know, I mean, how can you defend paying a dead man? It's pretty basic. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.